In this video, I'm going to show you how to install the actions in Photoshop. So let's pretend you've downloaded my Retouching Actions Pack. I'll put the download links in the description below. Go to Downloads here. So this is where you're going to find your downloaded files. So what you're going to do, or what you have to do, is to extract the files that are inside this zipped file. I'm using WinRAR, so I'm going to right click here and then I'm going to select Extract here. So this is the folder that we want. Let me just minimize this. I'm going to go on Window here, and then I'm going to select Actions here. So the action panel is going to pop up. I'm going to go on these four lines. I'm going to left click, and then I'm going to select Load Actions here. So from here, I'm going to look for that folder I extracted. I'm going to go to Downloads here, Compressed Files. This is the folder. I'm going to open it. So these are the actions you are going to find in my Retouching Actions Pack. I'm going to install all the actions in Photoshop. So I'm going to select the action. I can just double click on the action, or I can click here, Load Action. Then I'm going to go back to these four lines, Load Action. I'm going to select this one. So I keep doing this till I install all the actions in Photoshop. Okay, so I'm done. So I'm going to close this. Let me just close all the actions here. So what I'm going to do from here, I'm just going to arrange them the way I use them. Let me just drag it here. So I'm going to put the frequency separation on top, followed by frequency separation 8-bit, and then frequency separation 16-bit. So I'm done arranging the actions. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to go on these four lines, and then I'm going to select button mode here. Let me just make it smaller. So now let me show you how you can retouch your photos in less than 5 minutes using my Retouching Actions Pack. Let me just zoom it in like this. Let's start. So you can see 8 here, which means that the photo you are seeing here is an 8-bit image. So when I go on my actions here, I'm going to select the frequency separation 8-bit. I'm going to click on it like this. This box is going to pop up. I'm going to drag the radius to 30, and then I'm going to click OK. I'm going to open the folder, and then I'm going to select the color layer. I'm going to go on my tools, and then I'm going to select the lasso to here. I'm going to set my feather here to 20 pixels, and then I'm going to make a selection like this. I'm going to go to filter, blur, then Gaussian blur. I'm going to use the radius of 30. Then I'm going to click OK. I'll do the same this side. So instead of going to filter, blur, and then Gaussian blur, I'll just use the shortcut. The shortcut is here. I'm going to hold alternate plus control plus F on the keyboard. So I'm going to select this control plus alternate plus F on the keyboard to repeat the same action that I did. So I'm going to select this part. I'm going to go to filter, blur, then Gaussian blur. I'm going to reduce the radius because I don't want our nose to look flat. So I'm going to select the radius of 20, like that. So I'm going to select the texture layer here. Then I'm going to go to my tools, and then I'm going to select the clone stamp tool here. I'm going to hold alternate, and then I'll sample a clean part. I'll just paint it on the blemish that I want to remove. Alternate sample paint, alternate sample paint. So let me just close the frequency separation folder. It's our before, it's our after, it's our before, it's our after. So the frequency separation process tends to remove the textures from the skin. So I'm going to add back the textures. So I'm going to go to my actions here, and then I'm going to select the skin textures here. So this box is going to pop up. I'm just going to click OK. This box is going to pop up. I'm just going to click OK. So this box is important. This is where you control how soft you want the textures to be. So I'm going to drag the radius going this side. Looking at the photo, I'll stop when I'm okay with how soft I want the textures to be. 3.5 is okay. And then I'm going to click OK. So you can see the layer mask here is black, meaning the textures are behind this layer mask. So I'm going to go on my tools, and then I'm going to select the brush. So since the layer mask here is black, I'm going to set my foreground color here to white. So that when I paint white on this layer mask, I'm going to show my skin textures on this image. Opacity 100%, flow 100%, and then I'm just going to paint back where I want the textures to be. So I want some textures here. I want some textures even this side. I want some textures even here, even on a nose. I want some textures even here. So these are before, these are after, these are before, these are after. So let me just close the skin textures here. So the next thing that I'm going to do, I'm just going to whiten the eyes. I'm going to go on my actions here, and then I'm going to select the teeth and eye whitening. I'm just going to play it. I'm going to open the teeth and eye whitening folder. I'm going to select the photo filter. I'm going to go on my tools, and then I'm going to select the brush. Since the layer mask here is black, I'm going to set the foreground color here to white. And then I'll just paint where I want the eyes to be whiter. Let me just move this side. So I'm going to close the teeth and eye whitening folder. I want the eyes to look as realistic as possible. So I'm going to set my opacity to 50. I'm just going to go to my actions here, and then I'm going to select the image pop. So this box is going to pop up. Let me just move it here. And then I'm going to go on underlying layer here. I'm going to drag this triangle down this side. You can see this part, the brighter part. So these are the parts that I want to pop. So I'm going to alternate on the keyboard to make this transition smooth. So I'm going to just drag it this side. Let me just close it. So these are before, these are after, these are before, these are after. I don't want the effect to be all over the place. I just want the effect to be on some parts of her face. So I'm going to go on the layer mask. I'm going to invert it, Control I on the keyboard. With the brush selected, I'm going to set the foreground color here to white. I'm just going to paint where I want this effect to be. So I want this effect here. I also want this effect here. I want this effect even this side. I want the effect on her lips, that. So these are before, these are after, these are before, these are after. I just feel like the reds are too much, so I'm going to go on the actions here, and then I'm going to select reduce reds here. These are before, these are after, these are before, these are after. If I want, I can leave it like this, but I'm going to reduce the opacity to 30%, so before, so after, so before, so after. So the next thing that I'm going to do, I'm just going to sharpen the image. I'm going to make a visible stamp layer. So I'm going to hold Control plus Shift plus Alternate plus E on the keyboard to make a visible stamp layer. I'm going to go on my actions here, and then I'm going to select the image sharpening. So this box is going to pop up. This box is important because this is where you control how sharp you want your image to be. So if I take the radius all the way like this, the image will be more sharper. I want it to look as realistic as possible. So I'm going to take the radius to 0.8, and then I'm going to click OK. So these are before, these are after, these are before, these are after. Let me just reduce the opacity to maybe 60%. These are before, these are after. Let me close this. These are before all the adjustments, these are after. These are before, these are after. So this is how easy you can retouch your photos using my retouching actions pack. If you want to retouch fast and level up your retouching skills, you should check out my retouching actions pack. The link will be in the description below. If you want to learn how to install the LUTs in Photoshop, you should check this video on top. And if you want to learn how to retouch using my retouching actions pack, you should check this video down here.